My name is Kees Moeliker. I'm from the Netherlands. And this is the Natural History Museum in Rotterdam, where I work as a curator. Back in 1995, the museum got a new wing made of glass. And this was great for the museum because it was a real bird cellar. In those days, I developed an absolute ear for the sounds birds make when they hit the glass. On June 5th, 1995, I heard a tremendous bang against the glass. And then I looked out of the window and I saw this. The bird that caused the bang was a mallard duck laying flat on its belly on the ground, but next to the dead duck was a live duck. Then this happened. The live duck mounted the dead duck and started to copulate. Well, I'm an ornithologist. I said something's wrong here. One is dead, one is alive. It's copulation, it's necrophilia. And if you look careful, both are of the male sex. Homosexual necrophilia. So what I did, I took my camera, took my notebook, took a chair, and started to observe this behavior because it was new to me. I could do so because it took 75 minutes. This display took 75 minutes. After that, I had seen enough, made my pictures, made my notes, and I was getting hungry, it was an evening. So I went outside to collect the duck for the museum. Not before I checked the sex of the victim. This is a rare picture of a duck's penis. So it was indeed of the male sex. Here are my notes, and I kept my notes to myself for about 6 years. I could not share this new scientific phenomenon with my peers. But after 6 years, I decided to publish. Publish the first case of homosexual necrophilia in the mallard duck. Here's the situation. A is my office. B is from where I watched the display. B is the place where the duck hit the glass, and C is from where I watched it. And here are the ducks again. Well, this was a paper, a scientific case report, as you know, in science, 6 or 7 people read it, and that's it. And I basically forgot all about it. But a couple of years later, in 2003, I got a message from somebody from Harvard University telling me, hey, you've won a prize with your duck paper, the Ig Nobel Prize. And the Ig Nobel Prizes honor research that first make people laugh and then make them think. So, hey, never heard about this, but it's meant to make more people interested in science and technology. So I accepted the prize. I had to pay my own way to Cambridge, Massachusetts, to this beautiful theater at Harvard University to collect my Ig Nobel Prize. And it's my pleasure to present to you here at this theater the victim of homosexual necrophilia in the mallard. And that's the reason why you're here, why I'm here. After winning this Ig Nobel Prize, I was of course keen onto every remarkable animal behavior that could occur, but I didn't watch out for this my entire career. And people were sending me all kinds of duck-related stuff. I've got a nice collection. It's very varied. more importantly, people send me their observations of remarkable animal behavior. And I've said before, if there is an animal misbehaving on this planet, I know about it. So I'll give you a few examples. This is a mistake. This is a moose trying to copulate with a bronze statue of a bison. I contacted the owner of the statue, and he assured me that both the bison and the moose were damaged trunks. This is a frog trying to copulate with a goldfish. This was in the Netherlands 2 years ago. And these are Australian cane toads. The one below is a roadkill, and the one on top tries to copulate. And these are feral pigeons in Rotterdam, my hometown. And this behavior appears to be pretty common among feral pigeons. And here's a turkey in Wisconsin, US. It flew against the electric fence of a prison. And, the male was busy with his female for about a day while the inmates watched it. Yeah, this is a beautiful picture taken in Belgium 2 years ago on broad daylight in the middle of town, in a town called Sydney Klaas. And you see a male mallard and a female that's been run over by a car. And then this happened. So this is ordinary heterosexual necrophilia. The good thing about all these information and pictures is that I could write 2 books about it. They're still only available in Dutch. The first one is called The Engelman, the duck guy. The other one is called The Bilnaat van de Tick, that's the butt crack of the tick. And every year, since 1996, we organize that Duck Day on June 5th, the day, the moment the duck hit the museum. The duck comes out, we commemorate the tragic death, we erected a memorial sign, and what's very important, we try to find ways and discuss ways to prevent birds from colliding with glass windows, because that's the global problem. Only in the US, 1 billion dead birds a year. And when the ceremony is over, we go to the local Chinese restaurant where they have a 6-course duck. So if you're around on June 5th in Rotterdam, be sure that you're at the Natural History Museum, where at 5 to 6 p.m. I'll show up with the duck. Another good thing that happened to me was a TED talk I gave about the subject. That was a big audience. The duck was also there. And now it's now I'm even an opera writer, because you're here for the Homosexual Necrophiliac Duck Opera. And this opera is based entirely on my published paper. What you're going to hear and what you're going to see are the exact words and the exact events described in my paper. So I hope you enjoy this opera as much as I do. Thank you.
Thank you. that.